What inspires change? What motivates us? It's what's inside that moves us. What moves you? Get the Scion story at Scion.com.
I don't know where that bill came from. It's obvious to me it's another political ploy by the Democratic majority. This is just another attempt to focus on things that are not so important other than political posturing and not focusing on the job, which is getting a budget done.
Governor Eddie Calvo is referring to the passage of Bill 174 over the weekend, which caps GovGuam's spending on health insurance at $55 million, which is the cost of the exclusive contract that was offered by a company that is yet to be named. This contract would save $18 million.
We know that if we fund health insurance program at the most economical and beneficial plan, then we will have $18 million in savings. You know, $8 million to our people and tax, and $10 million to the taxpayers.
Senator Pangilinan says this $10 million savings could then go towards various things like public health, public safety, education, hay raises, and COLA. But Bill 174 has to be signed by the governor first. Then lawmakers can work on a budget that appropriates this $10 million in savings. So what will the governor do?
I think it's important before we move one way or the other, I want our folks to read the bill. Again, we had no opportunity to read it.
Whether or not the governor signs Bill 174 into law, the government of Guam has to come up with a budget before the fiscal year ends on September 30th. Senator Pangilinan believes that the legislature has satisfied the requirements of law that a budget be passed and submitted to the governor before August 30th. Now that the governor has vetoed that bill and the legislature has voted against the governor's budget bill, Senator Pangilinan says he's again willing to work with the governor.
I asked the governor to sit down with him when he said the budget was going to be dead on arrival. I offered, let's sit down, let's discuss what the priorities are and see if we come in. I repeat that offer, you know, and so I repeat that offer and I'm still willing to dialogue with the governor, as well as I think we're going to and continue to have dialogue among the senators for the next, where we go from here.
I've been willing to meet for him for months, actually for the past 3 years. I've invited him to many roundtables. I've invited him to bill signings for bills that I have signed that were his. I've invited him to a cup of coffee. I found it ironic that he, last time he wanted to meet with me, it was through a press conference. No offense to Senator Pangilinan, but it appears that his willingness to meet with me is a bit disingenuous, especially in a time when he should be working with his fellow senators.